Y'all, thanks for stopping by. If you're new here, please like and subscribe. Leave comments on anything I talk about that interests you. And I just enjoy you being here, joining me on this journey as I grow through YouTube. If you're returning, thank you for being here. Please like and subscribe, comment, and let me know all your opinions. Thank you for the kind subscribers who leave comments on all my videos. I see y'all. I love y'all. And we about to keep it going. As you see, I am here in less than a week. So I fulfilled my end of the deal. This video is going to be a little small. I just really wanted to get on the camera, truth be told, talk about a couple things, talk about a show that I've been watching. So yeah, let's get into it. This is Mo Media. Okay, I hope y'all have been doing well, as I've discussed earlier. I really want to talk to y'all because I've been enjoying this new season of Love & Hip Hop Atlanta. I love Yandy. She's a good addition to the cast. But I really wanted to come jump on here and talk about this whole Erica Mena and Safari situation. The streets saying that the whole storyline is fake. First of all, him posting in Jamaica, everybody was like, Safari, go home. Your baby's just getting out of the NICU. And Erica Mena's posting like, you know, I'm so sad, I'm by myself with the baby. And that's really a lot, dealing postpartum alone and a new baby. And, you know, she's a mother of three already. And this husband who's supposedly always working and vacationing. And that's what the storyline was. But they have people fooled, like they're getting the whole storyline messed up. Because Safari is on interviews. He was on Young Jock's radio station. It's in Atlanta. He was talking about some, I was at home. Every time I was posting in Jamaica, I was at home. Why didn't you post the baby? Why didn't you post comments under your wife's page showing her support if you were at home by her side? Like, this is storyline. And Mona, you got us. It's awesome. I heard Color Me Pink say that she's a fan of their relationship, and she saw them from the beginning, and she saw that Safari loves that woman. He would never do something like this. They're just chasing a check. I feel bad, but that's what it is. All right, yes, I am back here with a turtleneck because I am cold and I ate, so I'm back. But yeah, I hate to say it, Safari and Erica needed a check. That's the only reason. He's been so loyal, and Color Me Pink has told us on her channel, like, man, this is fake, because she saw them on their story. She saw their interactions even after the baby, and she has kids. Like, he's not, what do you think when you get married? You're not going to have kids? Like, I think him not approving of all this is very storyline-y. I agree with Color Me Pink here on YouTube, and I'm sticking to it. The next story entails the new track by Normani in 2 years called Wild Side featuring Cardi B. Impressive here on YouTube. She's a great channel, but she's very Nicki Minaj biased. She's a Barb, if you will. She put out the narrative that this was only for business and all that because Normani had said Cardi wanted to be on the song. Normani is a very big Cardi B fan. We know that she's enjoyed some of her hits throughout the years. You see her dancing in videos. There's receipts. And Cardi did a great verse. I thought her singing and harmonizing with Normani was awesome. The only valid argument that I've been seeing is it could have been another R&B singer. That would have been awesome. I need to see R&B with R&B action. I think people are just mixing with the same people, remixing with the same people. DaBaby, Megan Thee Stallion, Cardi B. Well, not so much Cardi B, but we need a genuine collabs. And not to say that this one wasn't genuine, but we need to see, you know, people in the same genre collab. I personally think this track is getting so much hate because people expected Normani to come out with a club banger and something upbeat, and she did not want to. Also, Aaliyah's father, my mistake, her uncle, had praised the song. His name is Barry something, I forget. He praised the song, but he said it would have been nice if her team had reached out to see if it was okay if they had sampled One in a Million. As you can tell, that boom, ch, boom. That song is sampled in 1 in a Million, but Normani Scamp claims that it is not sampling anything. It's not sampling. So y'all go listen to Normani's. Let's listen to it right now. Okay, y'all, this is the Aaliyah 1 in a Million intro. And she did her thing. Like, listen, I don't know if the family doesn't release the music because they don't want to relive that. And they know her legacy is rooted in, you know, what became. But man, oh man, oh man, the streams, the millions they could make because her music is so iconic. Anyways, let's go ahead and listen to the Wild Side intro. Oh. Wow. Wow. So upon listening, I don't hear a sample. I feel so bad, but no, there's no sample. It has an Aaliyah-esque feel to it. It's definitely kind of like the Just Dance, the covers, the knockoffs of something. You want to get the vibe. But it sounds great. I think the style, her being herself, the choreography, all pays tribute to Aaliyah in some way, but it isn't. In your memory, though, it sounds like a sample because, like, I just hear the vibe of the song. I hear a sample. Even listening back, I hear. Okay, guys. Chloe Bailey has announced a new track. Booty So Big Worth Lord. Have Mercy. It sounds awesome. It sounds good. Sounds like the glove banger that people want Normani to have. So it's going to do well. There's already a TikTok trend, a TikTok dance of it, and it hasn't even come out yet. So it's going to do extremely well. And all I can say is I hope Chloe does a great album rollout. In the industry right now, which I'm trying to break into, there's no album rollouts except for Chloe and Halle. They're the only person giving a whole era rollout with singles, performances, and you know, the whole album rollout, you know, format. Megan Thee Stallion, that can be argued, but she's not really great news. Was that her album, What's News, or something like that? It wasn't an era. It was just tracks. It felt like a mixtape. Her sync, she did release singles and do live performances and do the things that I had mentioned before. But the reason I don't consider it that is because it didn't feel like an era like Tina Snow and you know, Fever did. Columbia does well with their artists. I've known that. And especially with the Bailey girls being on Parkwood Entertainment, I know they're going to do traditional rollouts. I know Beyonce really cares about the craft and, you know, doing that type of thing, so it's expected. But I also expect it with Megan Thee Stallion because she's with Roc Nation, don't y'all? Megan Thee Stallion is doing her thing. It's just not eras. It's not a unit. It's not artistically put together as much as Ungodly Hour. The whole album was an era. They had Do It, which was the first single. They also have Forgive Me. It all carried the same kind of aesthetic but had different, you know, key points. And there's even singles that they haven't even released. Maybe they will now that Halle has finished her movie. But I don't know. That's my opinion. I've seen other fandoms, you know, other people, stands, music, scopes, music, spectators on TikTok. We've been talking about this. I don't wear makeup, but for anybody that cares, I told you guys before that Kim Kardashian was rebranding KKW Beauty. Now it's Skin with SKKN, Kim Kardashian. So awesome. Great to hear that she's rebranding, finding new ways to make money. Because at the end of the day, these are her kids' money when she passes. So get them some coin. Get them some coin. Her ex-husband, Kanye, released a sick trailer with his new track. Donda is the name of Kanye West's mother, who unfortunately passed after undergoing plastic surgery. and he feels guilty about it. It's shown in his music, and he's been depressed and guilty about it. He hasn't been the same, people have said. But he has kids. When you have kids, that's a new generation, and that instills hope, and that instills, a lot of things in a person. So who are we to just say, someone's mental state, even though they have shown signs of whatever, Last thing I got is, I know y'all saw this reboot. Well, it's not even a reboot. It's just a branching out of the Power universe. I love Power. It's a big, listen. I love Power. I love Ghosts, Power Book 2 with Tariq. And now I love Raising Kanan. It's so good. And I don't even want to get sucked in, but the episode was just so good. I couldn't help it. Y'all need to go check that out. It's on Stars. If you get Stars with Hulu or whatever the deal is, please check it out. Support these black people. They got 50 Cent narrating it. Great acting from the first episode. And of course, Kanan getting him into some BS, just like he was doing on Power. I love it. And Kanan is how Ghost got into it. Kanan's family is just in like that. So it goes all the way back to the 80s. I'm so excited for this. I'm so excited to see what the 80s cartel was like in the theme song. It even got some crack in there. I love it. I'll watch Snowfall. So I just wanted to tell y'all that that first episode was so good. Maybe I'll even start reviewing it because I enjoy these kinds of shows so much. I don't know if Power Book 2 is coming back. I'm sure it is, but I don't really keep up with it. When I hear it's coming back, I get on the train and I watch. So other than that, that's all. Let me know what y'all think about everything. Do y'all think that Safari really is abandoning his newborn just out of the NICU son and his wife? Or do y'all think this is BS? It's just something for them to get some coin, like I was saying. Do you think Normani will do like the Chloe and Halle sisters? Do you think they'll do a classic rollout that will leave classics and leave their fans satisfied as they go on to their new ventures? Or will she leave us dry like 2019 and just keep pushing out singles with features, just like What You Made Me Do, that Dancing with a Stranger, just like that one with Sam Smith, Love Lies. Did I say Sam Smith? I meant Khaled. That single with Khaled, Love Lies. We need to know what you're doing, Normani. But so far, so good. The song is awesome. You just pay Leah homage. Say you were paying her homage. We hear the vibe in the song. We don't want to know. We don't want to think that you're just stealing. Other than that, we cheer you on as the next Black It Girl. Other than that, I wish y'all well. God bless. I'll be back in like a couple of days since I usually do a Mo Media. But this is just a little one. I told you I wanted to be on the camera. I wanted to be on the camera low key. And I am. So have a good day. Peace.